Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my sixth lesson of D2, chapter number 5, exercise 5A, that is about solving quadratic equation by factorization. In this lesson, I will solve basic level question number 5 that says solve each of the following equations. Let's move to the lesson. First part of the question is 6x square minus 29x plus 20 equals to 0. We can see the question is in form of the standard quadratic equation. And the first term and the last term of the equation are not the perfect square. So we have to apply the hit and trial method for the solution of this equation. And as far hit and trial method is concerned, we have discussed a lot about this method. If you find any difficulty about the method, I'll give the link in the description box and you can watch the lesson from there for the better understanding of the lesson. Let's move to the question. First part of the question is 6x square minus 29x plus 20 equals to 0. Multiply constant with the coefficient of the term having part 2, that is 20 multiplied by 6. And that will give me the product 120. Now what I have to do, I have to make the prime factors of this product quickly. 2, how many times is 120? 2 60s are 230, and then again 2 is suitable, 215, and 3 5 times, and 5 1 times. Now what I have to do, I have to set these all factors in such a way that when I'm adding or subtracting, I'm getting minus 29, and when I'm multiplying, I'm getting 120. Now what I can do is, if I'm taking 2, 2's are 4, 2's are 8, 3's are 24 and 5, 24 and 5, 24 plus 5 can give me 29, and 24 multiplied by 5, let me check it, 5 4's are 20, 5 2's are 10 and 2 12, 120. So 24 and 5 is the suitable choice. Now it's a problem that 29 has the negative sign with that and the product is positive. So what sign we are going to attach with 24 and 25? Both the factors will have minus sign. Let's move to the solution. 6x square minus 24x minus 5x plus 20 equals to 0. Now my middle term is divided in two parts, and now this expression, the expression on the left hand side of the equation, is the application of factorization by grouping. What I have to do to solve this equation, I have to divide this part in the suitable groups. So from the first group, I can see 6x square minus 24x. I have to extract some number or letter as a common factor. From x and x square, we can see x is common, and from numbers 6 and 24, we know that 24 can come in table of 6. 6, how many times is 24? 6 4s are 24. So I have to pull out 6x here, and inside the bracket, I will left with x minus 4. Coming to the second part, we can see minus 5x plus 20. Table of 5 is suitable for 20 how many times? If I'm extracting 5 out, 5 outside the bracket, and then I have to think that what sign I have to take common here. If we look at my 5x term, it has some minus sign with that. But in the previous part, inside the bracket, we need the coefficient and sign of x positive. So what we will be doing, we will be extracting minus 5 out, and then inside the bracket from 5x, I've extracted minus 5 out and I will left with x. Coming to 20, we can see that 20 has the positive sign, but here we have extracted minus sign. So what sign I have to write here? That will be minus, because when I will be multiplying this minus sign by minus sign, my answer will be positive. 4 equals to 0. Now look carefully that this x minus 4 is the common group. X minus 4 is the common group. Extract it out, pull it out carefully. X minus 4 into 6x minus 5 equals to 0. In order to solve this equation, I have to apply either x minus 4 equals to 0 or 6x minus 5 equals to 0. In order to get the value of variable, I have to shift the constant to other side by changing the signs. So from the first equation, what I will be doing, I will be shifting this 4 to other side and I will get x equals to 4. Coming to the second equation, 6x equals to 5. Now x has the coefficient 6. I need the value of x with coefficient positive 1. So I have to shift that 6 to other side and x will be equals to 5 by 6. So the two solutions of this equation are x equals to 4 or 5 by 6. I hope you are clear about this question. Let's move to the next question. G part of the question is 3y square plus 7y minus 6 equals to 0. Again, multiply constant with the coefficient of term having part 2. That will give me 6 multiplied by 3 is 18 with minus sign. Quickly make the prime factors of this product. 2 how many times? 18, 2 9s are. And then table of 3 is suitable. 3 3s are and 3 1s are. Now what we have to do, we have to set these all factors in such a way that when I'm adding or subtracting, I'm getting the middle term, which is 7, and when I'm multiplying them, I'm getting 18. So if you look at the factors 3 and 3, 9, 9 and 2. If I'm taking these two numbers, 9 minus 2 will give me 7 and 9 multiplied by 2 is 18. So this is the suitable choice. So what we have to do is 3y square plus 9y minus 2y minus 6 equals to 0. Here I have split my middle term in two terms. Now we can see that as the middle term has the positive sign, so the bigger factor will have the positive sign and product is negative, so the other factor will have the negative sign. Now make the groups of like terms, make the groups of like terms and extract some number or letter as a common factor. If you look at the coefficients 3 and 9, we can extract 3 out, and from the letters y and y square, y can be taken as a common factor. Inside the bracket, I will left with y plus 3. Coming to the second group, we can see both the terms are having minus sign, so I will extract minus sign out. And for 6, table of 2 is suitable 3 times, so I will extract 2 out. So inside the bracket, I will left with y plus 3 equals to 0. Again, look carefully that this y plus 3 is the common group. Extract it out, y plus 3 into 3y minus 2 equals to 0. In order to solve this equation, I have to apply either or condition. Either y plus 3 equals to 0 or 3y minus 2 equals to 0. Shift 3 to other side to get the value of variable by changing the sign, and I will have y equals to minus 3. And for the second equation, again I have to shift this 2 to other side and I will have 3y equals to 2 and y equals to 2 by 3. So the two solutions of this equation are y equals to minus 3 or 2 by 3. I hope the lesson will not be difficult for you if you are clear about the hit and trial method. Let's move to the next part of the question. The question is 2z square minus 3z minus 14 equals to 0. Multiply constant with the coefficient of term having part 2 and the product comes 28 with minus sign. Now what I have to do with this product, I have to make the prime factors 28, 2 is the smallest suitable divisor, 2 how many times? 28. 2 14s are. Then 2 7s are. And 7 1s are. I'm getting the factors 2, 2, 7 and 1. I have to, from these all factors, I have to make 2 numbers only in such a way that when I'm adding or subtracting, I'm getting minus 3. And when I'm multiplying, I'm getting minus 28. So if I'm taking 4 and 7, 7 and 4, I hope this is the suitable choice. When I'm taking away 4 from 7, answer will be 3. And when I'm multiplying 7 by 4, answer will be 28. Now the problem is that what sign I have to mark with 7 and what sign I have to mark with 4, that is really important to understand. As the middle term has the negative sign, so the larger factor will have the negative sign. It is really important to understand. You have to focus on this step. 2z square minus 7z plus 4z minus 14 equals to 0. Now make the groups of like terms. Make the groups of like terms and from each group extract some number or letter as a common factor. If you look at 2z square minus 7z, we can just extract z out and inside the bracket I will left with 2z minus 7. Coming to the second part, we can see that 4 and 14 both can come in table of 2. So I will pull out 2 outside 2 and 2z. 2z minus 7 equals to 0. Now again, carefully look at this step and see. This is the common group. This is the common group. Extract it out. Pull it out. 2z minus 7 into z plus 2 equals to 0. In order to get the solution of this equation, apply either or condition, either 2z minus 7 equals to 0 or z plus 2 equals to 0. So for the solution of this equation, I have to shift this 7 to other side. I will have 2z equals to 7 and z equals to 7 by 2, or 7 by 2 can be written as 3 whole 1 by 2 z. Coming to the second part, I have to shift this 2 that is added to z to other side, and this will give me the solution z equals to minus 2. Z equals to minus 2. Z equals to minus 2. So the two solutions of this equation are z equals to 3 or 1 by 2 or z equals to minus 2. I hope you are clear about these all questions. Let's move to the next question. In the next question, we'll solve intermediate level question number 6 that says solve the following equation. 7x cubed plus 21x squared. Really easy question. We can see that the number 7 and 21, 7 and 21 are suitable for each other. And from the letters x cubed and x squared, we can extract x squared as a common factor. So what we will be doing, 7x cubed plus 21x squared equals to 0. Extract and pull out 7 and x squared as a common factor. Inside the bracket, from 7x cubed, I've taken 7x squared outside. X plus 3 equals to 0. Now, I have to apply either our condition, either 7x squared equals to 0 or x plus 3 equals to 0. In order to get value of x, what I have to do, I have to shift that 7 to other side. X square equals to 0 by 7 or x square equals to 0. And in order to get value of x, I have to take the square root on both sides. And one of the roots will be x equals to 0. Coming to the second part, x plus 3 equals to 0. Shift 3 to other side and that will give me x equals to minus 3. So the two solutions of this equation are x equals to 0 or x equals to minus 3. I hope you are clear about these all questions. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Like my lesson, share and subscribe the channel and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.